What is going on, YouTube? Joe here with Colonation Media, and welcome back to another episode of Pokemon Storm Silver. This is episode number 50, and today we're going to try as hard as we can to get over to Fuchsia City. I think we have one more route to work our way through after this one, so we'll see how that all works out, as it looks like we're going to have to battle a couple or more people just to get through this one. So we're going to do that. I've got Lynn out in front of the party to hopefully gain a little bit of experience and catch up a little bit. I think Blast and Carrasco are level 63, everyone else level 62. So we'll see what happens as we're going up against PokeFan Alex, and this is perfect. It's a perfect matchup against the Nidoking, which we can one-shot very easily with Psychic. So as we're getting started today, as I always say, just a friendly little reminder in case you guys haven't done so already and you would like to show some support to the channel and the series and all this fun stuff. I don't know why I put a weird inflection on that. But anyway, if you would like to do so, remember you can just do that by leaving your thoughts in the comment section or giving the video a thumbs up. All those things help. And it's just fun to hear from you guys. So there's that too. Lopunny's coming out. I could stay in an Aura Sphere, but in the off chance that you have Fake Out, that will pretty much be, like, take away 50% of poor Lynn's health because he just doesn't have any physical defense. And by he, I mean she, because it's a girl and I always want to call it a him, and it's not. A him, a he, everything, I just always associate male with Alakazam, and I think it's the mustache. That must be what does it. Anyway, there's no Fake Out here. Lopunny's just going to go down to a close combat. And you know what? That's actually fine with me. I am perfectly okay with that. Slowking. Slowking, Slowking, Slowking. I guess we could do Blast. I know our health is kind of lacking a little bit, but I think we might just be able to pull off a crunch one-shot here. I mean, we have a 5-level advantage, so we don't have to worry about taking any recoil with Wild Charge, or not Wild Charge, Volt Tackle. That's awesome that Luxray gets Volt Tackle in this game, by the way. That is absolutely incredible. Good job, Draiano. That's one of the better things that you did. I mean, a lot of the things that you did are great, but that's up there. How dare you mock my royalty? What royalty are you talking about? I'm so confused as to why you think you're royalty. Oh, geez, look at all these trainers. Okay, this is good. We're going to get a lot of experience. Maybe we won't make it all the way to Fuchsia, but we're going to try to get close. Because I know there's... What route is that? 15? At the bottom part of the map, I believe, has a lot of trainers all bunched together, too. Which I'm not complaining about. It just means that it's going to take another episode, probably, to get through all of that. And while that's not a bad thing, it feels like things are moving slowly because we don't actually make a lot of physical progress as far as moving. But, you know, a lot of things are happening. All right, so Floatzel just dies to a Psychic, and that was this person's only Pokemon. So you know what? I'm fine with that. Moving on. That was easy. We'll battle you next. Picnic or something. Why is it I always get the urge to whistle when walking through nature? With nature being capitalized. That is interesting. It's usually only capitalized when it's Mother Nature, at least that's all I've ever seen. But I guess if you're using it as a proper noun, I guess you would just capitalize it. I don't know, I'm not the grammar Nazi, I don't know English as well as I put off. Anyway, we'll see if this Moscarain can take a Psychic, and it can fairly well. And it goes for the Air Slash, which misses. So we can finish it off with a Shadow Ball. There's no reason to waste Psychic's PP, because we're not going to hit another Pokemon Center until we get to Fuchsia. So, who knows? We may have to use Psychic a lot if there's, like, Bike Riders or whatever they're called. Because they tend to have Weezings and Mucks and all kinds of things that Psychic is great for. Did I talk to you? No, I did not. Alright, well, we're going to battle you right now, then. We're just going to get right into it. I feel like we are actually making a lot of progress here. Hippowdon. Alright, I do not want to leave Lynn out on this because I'm not confident that Psychic will one-shot. And EQ probably will one-shot me in return. So our best bet here is probably Carrasco, I would think. Unless we think Alex can one-shot with an Ice Beam. I mean, it's Stab. Yeah, let's give it a go. Alex should be able to absorb an EQ from this thing and then fire off an Ice Beam. And we should outspeed it as well. He opts to go for the crunch, which is super effective, And that really did not do that much damage at all. So we should be able to take an EQ, maybe even a Stone Edge, without a critical hit, of course. But I don't think it's going to matter because we do outspeed. We get that stab. Choice Bex Ice Beam off, coming off our monster special attack. And I don't think Hippowdon's going to take this. Nope. And that is not a critical hit. That is just a dead Hippowdon. Down he goes. We get some experience. Almost growing up to level 63 is our Alex here. Hey, how about we exchange phone numbers before we eat? Who's we? I'm not eating with you. Where did you get that idea? What's wrong with you? Tanner, or whatever your name is. I don't know what to think. I don't know what to think about you. We'll put Carrasco out in the front to go up against this hiker here. Just because they tend to have rock and ground type Pokemon, and Carrasco kind of likes going up against them. You know what? If you want to send out a Graveler or a Golem, I'd be perfectly fine with that. Sandslash is fine as well. You do have some high defense, but we can go for Surf, because that will hit you on your lower special defense. It's still Stab. It'll be super effective, and unfortunately, our minus special attack nature may come into play here. Nope, never mind. It's still a one-shot, not a critical hit either. So Sandslash just cannot take the power of Carrasco. Golem is next. We definitely can stay out with Carrasco again. So Carrasco might pull a little bit ahead as far as experience is concerned here, which I'm okay with because, as I mentioned in the last episode, we're probably not going to use Carrasco at all in the gym, the Celadon gym coming up, because of the fact that his water-type moves are all going to be walled by all those grass-types like Vileplume, Blossom, and you know, and a lot of them are especially defensive too, so Dragon Pulse will do nothing. Bronzong is next, and I will send Roman out for this one. I know it could be heat proof, but even if it is heat proof, it might not be able to take an eruption. I'm not sure. We'll see. It's a level 59. That only gives us a 3-level advantage, but we are at full health, so this is going to be 150 base power. And we are holding the charcoal, so it's going to get boosted by that. It's going to get boosted by Stab. It's just, I don't see you living this. I'm sorry. Nope, 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 nope. He doesn't, you know what? Roman doesn't even need the critical hit. He wanted to prove a point right there. He said, I don't need to have critical hits on my side all the time. He doesn't really, though. He doesn't have critical hits on his side all the time because he often gets critted himself. Yeah, so moving on into the next route, I think. Switch Carrasco out of the front here. Lynn, you know what? We'll put Kirby out there. Let Kirby do some work. Actually, no, because Kirby is going to get a lot of work in the gym, too. I know Lynn might because of the poison types, but Kirby's pluck should be super effective on just about everything there. All right. Going down to Route 14, this is Cameron the photographer. All right, we look photogenic. He always tells us we look photogenic. But you know what? I like the windmills here. We'll see if we can get that in the shot. We're kind of facing away from it. Oh, no, there's part of it. We looked a little bit bunched together there. I feel like we could have utilized the room that we had to work with a little better there, but that's okay. Let's battle you. Bird Keeper. My weight puts me in the featherweight class, huh? What do you mean that doesn't sound very strong? You just wanted to say featherweight because you're a bird keeper. Although you probably would be in the featherweight class. Just saying. Alright, Altaria is here. Who am I to talk? I am a skinny runt. Alright, Psychic. That's not going to kill in any universe because it's an Altaria with very high special defense. But it should be 2 a KO, which it is. And we'll see what he wants to do back. Dragon Breath, don't you dare paralyze our beloved Lynn. Don't you dare do it. Don't. I said don't. That's a negative. That means do not do it. Why do you not understand this? Go for a Psychic again. He pulls out the Dragon Breath. The reason I didn't want to go for a full heal or a paralyze heal is because I knew he was going to do this again, and we were going to get paralyzed. Again, for a second time. That's just what it is. All right, so Psychic takes out the Altaria, and it's just a good time. Oh yeah, Shell Bell recovery, that's always good. Definitely always good. Almost growing up to level 63. I definitely want to heal you up and continue to use you, though. I want you to grow up to level 63. No, I don't want your phone number after you just blatantly disobeyed my wishes. You went against my wishes. I guess you can't obey wishes. Doesn't work like that. But you know what I'm saying? Like, I asked you very politely, and then I was very demanding, very straightforward about the fact that I did not want you to paralyze Lynn. And what did you do? Paralyze Lynn. There's no forgiving that in my book. All right, let's give you, what was that? Was that lemonade? Soda pop. Apparently Lynn likes soda pop too. We need to get our full heals. Where are they? 438 of them. Yes, that's way too many. We could sell 400 of those and be fine probably for the rest of the game. Maybe not that much. Maybe like 350. Oh, hello, Suicune. I didn't even notice you just chilling over there. And he's gonna run away again. Ah, Yusine is here. Oh no, we're gonna have to battle you again. I don't want to battle you right now. Not again! I'll be there first next time. Having followed it here, I'm starting to understand what Suicune is after. To be honest, I would like to keep this information to myself. You don't want to share this with me? That's not very nice. But I want to be an honest trainer in front of Suicune. That's why I'm sharing a clue with you. It seems that Suicune prefers a hilly place near water, somewhere north. I don't know exactly where yet. It will just be you and me. Who will find it first? I challenge you. Oh, and he's just going to stay here. What's wrong? To be honest, I would like... he's just going to continue to say the same thing. A hilly place near water somewhere north. Well, let's take a look at the map. Let's just try to figure out maybe where. Here in Kanto. Somewhere north. Like up here. What is this? Mount Moon? That could be it. In that little, that watery area. There's a lot of hills over there. What is this? Cerulean Cave? Not, probably not. It's not really hilly. Maybe it could be out by the cape. There's some water up there. It's not like ocean or anything. What is this? Route 25. A path that winds through the forest and comes out overlooking the sea. Oh, that could be it. Well, that is the cape. Never mind. I was getting a little bit confused and turned around there. What is this? This is Pewter City, so it's got to be somewhere in this area. It's one of those, I would think. All right. I was just out of curiosity trying to figure things out here. So I'm guessing you're going to battle me since you're not Cameron. Sometimes I go back to the places I met my Pokemon. They bring back good memories. Well, isn't that good for you? That's just fantastic. You only have one Pokemon, though. Pokefan Trevor, and he has a Jumpluff at level 61. Alright, so we're probably not one-shotting this, but we can go for a Psychic and see how much it does. It should do maybe about 75%, I would think, to a Jumpluff, maybe a little more. Okay, that's definitely more, and that is a one-shot because it is a critical hit. We've been getting a lot of those lately. I'll be honest, most of them have been going our way, which is unusual. But I will take it. And because of that, we got all of that Shellbell HP recovery. So maybe I didn't need to use a Soda Pop. Could have just gotten a majority of it back via the Shellbell. That's kind of what it's there for. But I will take it. I will freaking take it. All right, let's put Kirby out in the front, I guess. Or Alex. We'll do Alex. Why not? Alright, so I guess it doesn't matter which way we go. Oh my gosh, look at all these trainers. Okay, let's get to it. Let's at least try to get through these four trainers before this episode is over. Which we should be able to, because we're not that far into it. Alright, Linoone is here, level 62. Interesting. I don't know if we can one-shot with Ice Beam, so I will go for Icy Wind here. As he goes for the Belly Drum, Linoone, I should have went for Ice Beam. Please don't have extreme speed. Please don't have extreme speed. Oh my goodness. I was about to freak out if Icy Beam Icy Wind missed as well. That should kill, right? Right? Thank you. Good job, Alex. Thank you, Choice Specs, as well. Alex is going to grow up to level 63 here, which is fantastic. And crisis averted as Alex is trying to learn Barrier, which is actually a pretty good move. It's, you know, similar to Iron Defense and... what else? Something else. I can't think of it at the moment. Acid Armor, I guess. But we're not going to teach it to him. And we have a double battle up here. unless we want to take it individually, but I don't want to take it individually, so that's that. We'll leave it as is. Kirby can be up there. What is it with the graphical errors lately? There's been so many of them. All right, let's do this. Let's do this. There has to be an item or something up here that all of these trainers are guarding. It's good to put what you learn to use immediately. Okay. Well, I guess you've been studying or something. You have something that you want to put to use. As Linoon is starting off alongside a Sandslash. Level 60 Linoon. That is a bit scary. I think I will stick with the Icy Wind. Will I? We might be able to just one-shot all of these things. We can go for Ice Beam on Sandslash and then Close Combat on Linoon. That might work. So we do go first. So we outspeed the Linoon. And I'm pretty sure that should be enough for a one-shot. If it's not, we might be in trouble. But it is. I mean, Linoon, it's a Linoon. It's really... It's not like extra frail, but it doesn't take hits very well. So there we go. Linoon is down, which means another potential belly drum crisis averted. Alex does outspeed Sandslash. And, I mean, as he should. Because this is a level 57, he's a level 63. That is, you know, quite a big difference when it comes to speed. And down it goes. Roserade is coming out next. Alongside Cast Form. Alright, so this works out still. I think that Roserade will outspeed Alex, but we'll go for the Icy... I always mix those two up. Ice Beam, not Icy anything. And we can go for Close Combat on Cast Form, because he is a pure normal type, because there is no weather going on at the moment. So that should take it out, I would think. Yes, down goes the Cast Form. Roserade will be going down as well, unless he nails like a critical hit Leaf Storm on Alex or something. Maybe I shouldn't have said that. Hopefully I didn't just jinx something. Petal Dance on Kirby. Okay, that's not going to do anything. That does absolutely... Okay, never mind. That's a critical hit. That is a critical hit. It's not a critical hit. Was Petal Dance not grass type? Did it say not very effective? That did so much damage. Oh my goodness. Oh, my defenses have been dropped. Okay, that's why. I was about to say, that's an insane amount of damage, but we used Close Combat twice, so we're at minus two special defense, so now it is all making sense. I was just derping a little bit there. All right, so there we go. It takes care of those two. And nope. We're not going to meet ever again. I'm never coming back here. We're never battling again. I don't even want to see you again. Do you have after-school study sessions? Do I look like I have time for school? I'm on a freaking adventure. School kid Travis. We don't all have time for, you know, nerd behavior. Actually, we do. I'm playing a Pokemon game, so clearly I have lots of free time that I should be spending doing other things. I'm just kidding. He has Levitate. I forgot. I was thinking he had Inner Focus because that's what normal Glalies have. And now we're locked into Earth Power. Not that it would matter, because we have two ice moves, which would be not very effective. Water Pulse actually would be super effective, because he's part rock in this hack. I don't like that. And he's going for Ice Beam on an ice type, so there's no reason to switch in Kirby on that, because I'll just get destroyed by it. Let's see. I'll switch in Lin. We can take an Ice Beam and then fire off a nice little aura sphere, which will be four times super effective. Oh, he opted to go for Head Smash, mixed Glalie. That would have been a dead Lin. Definitely that would have been a one-shot with our pitiful physical defense. I'm kind of surprised he didn't go for the Head Smash the first turn if you had it. Unless you were really just on some next level stuff right there and predicting me to switch out at the first turn, and that's why you went for the Ice Beam. Possibly predicting, it's not like you know what my team is, but still, I was tempted to switch in Pidgeot there, and that would have been a disaster, obviously. Alright, so all of this to get to this lady right here, are you just gonna battle me? Do you know which is the cutest Pokemon in the world? It's Chansey, of course. I say Chansey, and that's final. I will give you something good if you can bring me a Chansey. Okay, maybe she'll give me, like, one of those plates, but I don't have a Chansey. So I had to battle all these people to come over to give you a chancy, to have the opportunity to give you a chancy. I thought I battled you already. I guess not. Let me tell you, I had a hard time catching my prize Pokemon. I'm sure you did. I'm sure you did. And he's got three of them. And he's starting off with Venusaur, level 60. Level 60 Venusaur. Okay, we'll go for an Ice Beam. Because you don't have thick fat, you're not Mega Evolving anytime soon. You still have two gens to wait before you can even think about Mega Evolving. So you are just going to go down in one hit. Goodbye. Goodbye, Venusaur. And we'll see what he has next. Blastoise? No, Charizard. Typical. Alright. I would say Blast can come out and just hit it with Strength, but the question is, do I trust Blast to actually outspeed a Charizard? I don't know that I do. So I will switch in Carrasco here. I still don't know if Carrasco can outspeed, but we should be able to hit him up with a Waterfall, which I would think would one-shot. I would hope, I should say. And we do outspeed, so on the off chance that he actually does survive this Waterfall here, there is the opportunity for us to get a flinch, which would be pretty cool. Pretty cool, but it's not going to matter because Charizard is just going to go down in one hit, and it's not even a critical hit. He just can't take Waterfalls from Carrasco. It's just what it is. And Carrasco's going to grow up to level 64, which is awesome. Blastoise is the final Pokemon to come out. And we'll send Blast out to give him a nice little Volt Tackle, which I hope doesn't kill us in the process. I didn't even think about that. The recoil is real. Maybe we should heal up first and then go for it. Provided that he doesn't have EQ, of course. Hyper Potion. And we'll see what happens. Please don't have EQ. Please don't have EQ. No, you have Rain Dance. Okay, that's perfect because I should outspeed you. And now we really need Volt Tackle to kill because Surf or Hydro Pump will kill us afterwards if we don't get the desired damage output here. But we're going to go for it. Look at that. Animation is so cool. Oh, it is so cool. One of the best of fourth gen for sure. And come on. Down he goes. And that, I think it would have killed us. That was about 54 HP and recoil that we took. Did we have 54 HP? I thought we had 51. Maybe it was 56. I don't know. It would have been dangerously close, and we didn't want to play those games. We don't mess around when we're talking about Blast's life is at stake here, or his livelihood. All right, so we got to battle this dude over here, and then we have then we get onto Route 15, and I'm sure there's going to be quite a few trainers over here as well. There's at least one. And it looks like we have to go that way. Okay, so we're going to figure things out. I'm actually going to call it an episode here. It's been, I think, about 20 minutes. Let me just double check my clock. It's been about 23, 24 minutes. So that's pretty good for an episode. I want to try to keep them at or below the half hour mark, if possible, because that extra time adds up, and I know it's not a big deal on one episode, but if we do that, I can give you an extra video or two, which means some days while I'm on vacation, you might have two videos, whereas, you know, if I didn't do that, I might not have that extra video to put out. So, you know, it's essentially the same amount of content, just split into different videos, but it gives you some extra videos per day to look forward to if, you know, you're off from school or work because of the holidays or whatever it is. But anyway, that is going to be it for this time. So I hope you guys enjoyed this episode. If you did, please make sure you're leaving a like rating or a comment or whatever you would like to do. Next time, we are heading to Fuchsia City and nothing is going to stop us. But until then, game on.